Today we're going to have an aircraft type review. Today's aircraft is the relatively new P-8 Poseidon, one of the many offshoots of the Boeing 737 family, which itself has been flying since 1967. It has not only led to the P-8 Poseidon, which we are covering today, but has also led to 13 civilian variants in 4 generations, and numerous and varied military applications from VIP transport, submarine hunter, and airborne radar, to name a few. The P-8 Poseidons are powered by 2 CFM International 56 high bypass turbofans, producing up to 27,000 pounds force or 121 kilonewtons each. Each aircraft has a flight crew of 2 and a mission crew of up to 7. On a combat mission, the aircraft can cover a designated area for over 4 hours, and the aircraft has a cruise speed of 440 knots or 815 kilometers an hour, with a normal range of 1,200 nautical miles or 2,200 kilometers. However, the P-8 Poseidon aircraft has a ferry range of 4,500 nautical miles or 8,300 kilometers, and as with most military aircraft of this size, the P-8s can be refueled in midair to extend their ranges and their combat mission time. Initial development started in 2000, as the U.S. Navy saw that the current P-3 Orions were too slow, getting too old, and too expensive to maintain them. Having been in service themselves since 1962, 3 proposals were brought before the U.S. Navy. Lockheed proposed an updated version of the venerable P-3 Orion, at the time called Orion 21. Boeing proposed an aircraft based on the 737-800 model, and BAE proposed a new version of the Nimrod Submarine Hunter, but quickly withdrew since they were not able to secure a stateside builder, making the bid politically unfeasible. In 2004, a contract for at least 150 aircraft was awarded to Boeing for the P-8 Poseidon. These aircraft were initially equipped with legacy systems from their P-3 cousins, but are able to be easily upgraded with new technology as they come online. The P-8's first flight took place in April of 2009, with the second and third aircraft flying in mid-2010, around the same time that low-rate production was ordered. Testing the sonar voice began in 2010. The first aircraft was delivered in March of 2012 to Naval Air Station Jacksonville, Florida. Training soon began with Patrol Squadron 30 out of that same base. In 2013, the aircraft demonstrated the ability to fire harpoon missiles. By 2014, full-rate production had been ordered, once the aircraft satisfied government inspectors of the aircraft's survivability and longevity. System upgrades at this time allowed the aircraft to increase submarine hunting capability without a magnetic anomaly detector, as had been seen in the old P-3 Orions. One of the interesting design features of the P-8 is that while the fuselage is based on the 737-800, the wings are from the 737-900 model, with raked wingtips at the ends. The aircraft have higher-powered onboard electrical generators to support the increased electrical load of the combat gear on board. The aircraft has an internal bomb bay located aft of the main landing gear and several wing hardpoints that can carry missiles or torpedoes. Other modifications allow the dropping of torpedoes from 30,000 feet or 9,100 meters. The P-8 can also operate drones remotely from the aircraft to extend its sensor range. The aircraft currently is not only serving with the U.S. Navy, but also the militaries of India, Great Britain, South Korea, Australia, Norway, and others. With future orders potentially coming from Brazil, Canada, amongst others, as of late 2022, there are 155 P-8s operating around the world, with many more on order. If you have friends or family who collect, please share the news of our channel and spread the word. And as always, thank you and like and subscribe. If you liked what you have seen, there are more videos available at the links you can see here, pointed out by my merry elephant friend, as well as a link to my channel. And thank you.